13 Ways of Looking at a Black Book by Wallace Stevens. Among 20 snowy mountains, the only moving thing was the eye of the black book. I was of three minds like a tree, in which there are three blackbirds. The blackbird whirled in the autumn winds, it was a small part of the pantomime. A man and a woman are one, a man and a woman and a blackbird are one. I do not know which to prefer, the beauty of inflictions or the beauty of innuendos. Blackbird whistling, or just after. Icicles filled the long window with barbaric glass. The shadow of the blackbird crossed it to and fro. The mood traced in the shadow an indepictable cause. O thin men of Handham, why do you imagine golden birds? Not see how the blackbird walks around the feet of the woman about you. I know noble accents, elusive and inescapable rhythms, but I know too that the blackbird is involved in what I do. When the blackbird flew out of sight, it marked the edge of one of many circles. At the sight of blackbirds flying in the green light, even the bards I already knew crowd sharply. We rode over Connecticut in a glass coach, once a fear pierced him. And he mistook the shadow of his equipage for blackbirds. The river is moving, the blackbird must be falling. It was evening all afternoon, it was snowing, and it was going to snow. The blackbird sat in the cedar limbs.
The Tiger by William Blake. Tiger, tiger, burning bright, in the forest of the night, what immortal hand or eye could frame thy fearful symmetry. In what distant deeps or skies burnt the fire of thine eyes? On what wings dare he aspire? What the hand dare seize the fire? And what shoulder and what art could twist the sinews of thy heart? And when thy heart begin to beat, what dread hand and what dread feet? When the stars threw down their spears and watered heaven with their tears, did he smile his work to see? Did he who made the lamb make thee? Tiger, tiger, burning bright in the forest of the night, what immortal hand or eye dare frame thy fearful symmetry?
Traveling through the dark, I found a deer, dead, on the edge of Wilson River Road. It's usually best to roll them into the canyon. That road is narrow. The sport might make more dead. By glow of the taillight, I stumbled back off the car and stood by the heap, a doe, a recent kill. She's stiffened already, almost cold. I dragged her off. She was large in the belly. My fingers touching her side brought me the reason. Her side was warm. Her fawn lay there waiting, alive, still, never to be born. Beside that mountain road, I hesitated. The car aimed ahead its lower parking lights. Under the hood purred the steady engine. I stood in the glare of the warm exhaust turning red. Around our group, I could hear the wilderness listen. I thought hard for all of us, my only swerving, and pushed her over the edge into the river.
White magic. The Gengi kicks off her wrinkled skin, clamp her soul in a jar. A half-wolf man can trot with bending elbows, rising grin, and lockjaw glowing can throw up. Sensors dissolve the ground fog and its whistling wandering souls, unbaptized, unfinished, and uncursed by holy fat. The islands grow its love, our mushroom elves, the devil is pastorals who keep like grub from a tree's rotten hearts. Their mouths are stream, and their club feet reversed. Exorcism cannot anchorize those signs we hear past midnight in the wood where pale woman like blind owl flies to her forking branch, with scarlet moons for eyes bubbling with doubt. You hear a silver splash, it's nothing. It slid from the moss rocks, dismiss it as a tired crab or fish. Unless our water mother with dank locks and slung under the page below your pen. Only a simple people can think that. Dryads and hemorrhoids were enraged in this wood's bark and papyrus on this paper, but when our dry leaves crackle to the deer-footed howling hunter Hubbubus, he just pans clone, or more translated servant. The clone who sips from her cheek sack sugar, thought you lit wine and lit linens with white flour. The bolon creeping towards you front to back, the ferny-footed, faceless, mouse-eared elves, these fables of blackwood and the poor marbled by the moonlight, who grow bright and richer. I miss our ignorance, theirs are the richer.